There were 11 games on the NHL slate Saturday, none bigger than the tilt in Pittsburgh, where each captain carried their club in search of two huge points. The Stars franchise record 8-game winning streak ran into a buzzsaw by the name of Connor Bedard. Mitch Marner is back after missing 12 games with an ankle injury, but no surprise, it was Austin Matthews lighting the lamp on his way to point number 100. And we close out the night with a possible first-round preview between the Canucks and Kings. I'm Tony Luffman. On the Fly starts now.
Division champions. Vladimir Tarasenko sends it in. Straight pops off the back glass. Right out in front, and they score. What a break for Florida. Matthew Tkachuk, 37 seconds in. It took a very strange bounce off the back glass and came right out in front of the net. And Tkachuk makes it 1-0 for the Cats. Tarasenko got knocked down by Lindholm. Now Danton Heinen, Charlie McAvoy scores. Charlie McAvoy snuck in from the blue line. Defenseman has Boston on the board. It's 1-1. The Bruins have been encouraging McAvoy to shoot the puck a little more. He's the beneficiary of a great pinch by Hampus Lindholm.
Boston on the power play.
Now he does down low. And a spot made by Omar on Anton Lundell, who comes to Boston having scored a goal in each of the last two. Odd bounce and an offside.
As he puts his hand up, he grabs the front of Coyle's jersey, and the next thing you see is his glove goes up and smacks him right in the nose.
How about this game as a tone setter should these two meet in the playoffs? Boquist, the shot! It's behind Bobrovsky, still free in the crease! Still free! And they got a whistle even though it was not covered.
It hits the back left heel of Bobrovsky. Now when he dives back, his big worry is not to knock it in his own net. The Panthers maybe catch a little bit of a break
on
that.
Yeah, that's a big break. I mean, it was clearly free.
Off it goes. Geeky stopped by Bobrovsky, who flashed up the left arm. Coyle centers for a one-timer by Marchand.
Frozen by Bobrovsky, the 35-year-old netminder from Russia, sharp again today in the cage for the Cats.
There's a penalty. Boy, that's blatant. Tkachuk is arguing. I can't believe that he is. He just plastered Wotherspoon from behind into the boards.
Boston 0 for its last 13 on the power play with the 0 for 3 today. Marchand, some room.
Down low, they score! Charlie Coyle, the tip-in! A power play goal! 2-1 Boston lead.
Charlie Coyle's been pushed out of his comfort zone a bit. They need him to provide offense this year. He's responded beautifully with a terrific year. So we'll get a little 4-on-4.
Great pressure here by the Cats. Tried to get a shooting lane, but Zacha was in the way. Reinhardt, his shot, rebound, goal!
Sasha Barkov ties it for Florida with 14:36 to go.
23rd of the year for Barkov. That's a 7-game point streak now, extending the longest of his season.
Leading to a chance for Lundell. Drops it off and a beautiful glove save. Linus Omar keeps it tied at 2 as he flashed the glove up to make a magnificent stop. Overtime has not been good to Boston. Marchand trying to avoid that. Free puck for Geeky. And neither one of them could get it behind Bobrovsky. Oh, a great chance for Marchand and a follow. And we'll have overtime. Here's a takeaway by Boquist. Boquist scores! Jesper Boquist wins it in overtime for Boston.
And this is a perfect shot by Boquist. He'd been recalled 3 times this year. He gets a chance in overtime and he puts it away. A beauty.
Everybody's really comfortable with who we are, how we need to execute, the effort it required, and the physicality that's required. I think that's where our group now has confidence in how to close out games, how to take games, and how to push games out of reach. We just kept battling. And that's what I like, is that we're just sticking with the process. We're staying in the moment. We're on to the next shift. We're not worried about anything good or bad that's happened in the past. We're moving on.
The Bruins had Florida's number all season. All four matchups going to the B, sweeping the season series for the first time since 2016-17. Don't let the records fool you, though. Three of the games were decided by just one goal, and two went to overtime. Boston now leads the Atlantic Division by 5 points. So, six teams, two spots, 13 days left in the regular season, and yet, still no answer to the question, who wants to make the Eastern Conference playoffs? We enter Saturday with the Islanders third in the Metro and the Flyers in the second wildcard spot. But no team hotter than the Penguins, looking to extend their point streak to 8 games. Pittsburgh could end the day in playoff position for the first time since November 14th. To do that, they'd have to take down the red-hot Lightning. Let's check it out.
6 games to go for the Penguins. Lurking in the Eastern Conference playoff picture with Sidney Crosby only one goal away from what would be his third 40-goal season. Couldn't keep it onside. Possible 2-on-1. Rust across the line with Crosby. Rust holds after Crosby. Score! The top line does it again for Pittsburgh, and the Penguins have the early lead.
Good move there. Finds Crosby backdoor for his 40th of the year.
Closing in on the end of his second decade in the National Hockey League, and he's a 40-goal scorer for the third time in his career. Amazing. Work to the point. Long wrist shot. Score! Was it tipped by Malkin? Fired by Carlson. 2-0 Pittsburgh. That shot changed direction, and it looks like Malkin will get the goal. So the best power play season long in the NHL. The Lightning, and this is their first chance. Kucherov checked by Eller. Finds Hedman. Stamkos drive. Score! From his office, Steven Stamkos gets the Lightning on the board. Letang at the point. Trickles through Vasilevskiy, and the Penguins answer. They've got their two-goal lead back.
And just squeaks through Vasilevskiy.
Losing his footing was Glendening. And there's a puck one again out in front. Malkin scores! Off the feed from Bunting. 4-1 Penguins.
All by himself in front. Gets one, two opportunities at this. Malkin's dad in the stands. What a proud dad. Look at that. That's great. No matter how long your kid's played in the NHL, I'm sure, how many goals he's scored, everyone's special.
Do the Lightning have a third period push and answer? Score! Paul, a quick trigger. And just like that, 25 seconds into the third period, the Lightning breathe a little life. Long outlet pass to Bemstrom, but a lot of traffic and a collision in the neutral zone. One of the officials is down, and this is a scary moment as the players want trainers from both benches to possibly come out on the ice. What a very scary moment. And on the right side of your screen, there was the collision between Kazari and Hayden Fleury. And according to Leah Hextall, lost consciousness for a moment, but was communicating with the EMS personnel. And now both teams saluting Kazari. Every player off of the bench for both teams. Victor Hedman is there. Off to Kucherov. DeClaire is the trailer. Wrist shot. Score! It's a one-goal game with a lot of time on the clock as Anthony DeClaire makes it 4-3 Pittsburgh. The left point. Hedman all the way across to Kucherov. Back to Hedman. Between the rings. Stamkos. Score! Another one-time corner pick by the captain. And unbelievably, we are tied. Carlson has it at the right point. Long wrist shot. Got it again towards the net. The rebound. Score! Bunting! Pittsburgh back on top.
And you can see the emotion on the Pittsburgh Penguins players. That's a huge goal as they try to fight their way back into the playoffs.
Stamkos wins it. Kucherov. One-timer. Save made. Nedeljkovic keeps it moving. And the final seconds tick off. Pittsburgh survives.
I think, you know, what we have to do hasn't changed, you know, for a while now. So,
you know, our game is, has been pretty good, and we just got to continue to go game at a time here, and I think that's a good thing for us. We don't have to change a whole lot. We just got to keep going. Yeah, winning helps, but I think that, you know, just continuing to battle and fight and find ways. I mean, that's been our mentality. I think that we had a few games that we weren't happy with there around the deadline, and I think we're able to move by those and just, you know, focus on the game in front of us. And like I said, that's been our approach, and it's been a big part of our success.
That captain knows what he's talking about. Crosby and the Penguins have been on fire. 6-0-2 in their last 8 games, thanks to their star players, led by their captain, Sidney Crosby. He, Evgeny Malkin, Brian Rust, and Chris Letang have combined for 19 goals and 25 assists during this crazy push to the playoffs. And after the game, this statement from the NHL. Referee Steve Cozzari was transported to UPMC Mercy Hospital for precautionary reasons after a collision with Tampa Bay defenseman Hayden Fleury in the third period of the Penguins Lightning game this afternoon. Cozzari is conscious and alert and has the use of all of his extremities and is expected to make a full recovery.
Predators have a clinching scenario tonight. The Minnesota Wild have lost, so the Predators can win tonight. And if the Blues lose in regulation tonight, Nashville can put the X next to their name.
Down a career year. Here's a takeaway. Cizikas battling in, tries to motor to the front, and knocked off balance. And this one's covered up by Lincoln. Franchise record for most goals in a single season. Here's a stretch pass right on the mark. Horvat shot off the post.
What a pass there by Ryan Pollock. A couple of quick steps, got his feet moving, and saw Horvat streaking down that left side.
Who has 58 assists. Keep an eye on him. Steal right in front. Here's a great save by Varlamov. Rebound off the post. Great work by Varlamov in some serious trouble.
Filters it through. Clutterbuck on for Matt Martin. Martin across the little room there, and then running out of runway was Riley. Still got to the side of the crease.
Dobson's going to get this puck. He's just going to put it right here, that right pad across, and just gets it with the toe. And Lankinen and save the day.
Philip Forsberg tries to wrap around. It's loose in front. Reaching for it, O'Reilly. Poked out of there. Forsberg has it back. Turns and shoots. A kick save by Varlamov.
Shot off the post in the first period for Horvat. Here's Riley. Across, Dobson shoots and scores! Noah Dobson had the game winner in Columbus on Thursday. He's got the first one tonight against Nashville.
The Omnis come up with some speed and they just go to work. D to D, okay, nothing there. Let me give it right back to him. Lots of traffic in front.
He had a lot of net to shoot at. Nice work in front of the net.
Hands it off.
Forsberg, ricochet. Novak sends it wide. Rebound Forsberg. Varlamov out of the net. And Forsberg has drawn a penalty.
On the side, he was looking to wrap, and then Dobson took him out of the play.
Islanders clear. They'll get numbers up ice. Palmieri on a 2-on-1. Has Pajot shot with a rebound. There comes back in front and unable to get it to go as Palmieri.
Evangelista gets high stick, and a penalty call is coming up. And Nashville has an opportunity.
And here comes Casey Cizikas. Cizikas in, throws on the brakes and twists it just off the mark. One penalty ends. The Islanders going to go back on the kills.
Changes the angle.
Fires.
Knocked down in front.
O'Reilly from the slot. Saved by Varlamov.
Back to Forsberg. Nashville all over the net.
He shoots, and a great save by Varlamov with the leather.
Fans chanting Varley right now in respect of the work of Semyon Varlamov.
Open man, McDonough. Into the traffic, rebound! And trying to reach through his legs, Forsberg to get to it. Now Forsberg in front. Zit just wide. Nashville all over the net.
Off the post. Off the side of the net again.
And so the Islanders will have to fend off a 6-on-5. They have an empty net to shoot at. Below the goal line, the return pass his way. Take it away, and at an empty net, Palmieri bullseye! The exclamation point for Semyon Varlamov and the Islanders. It's a 39-save shutout. Take down the Preds.
The Islanders just keep on winning with the shutout victory over the Predators on Saturday, led by Semyon Varlamov's 41 saves. The Isles are now 5-1-0 in their last 6 games. During the stretch, scoring an average of 2.67 goals per game, and they are playing very well defensively.
Well, there's no doubt about it. The Flyers need 2 points tonight as they're winless in the last 6 games and now on the outside looking in the playoff picture in the Eastern Conference.
We drop the puck. Flyers trying to get themselves back into playoff position with a victory.
Get some help there and support the Panthers.
Good job down low by the Flyers. They're on their, or by the Blue Jackets. They're on the toes. They're pushing back the Flyers. And then that shot comes through. Harrison does not see it whatsoever.
Bronkov gets it back to Gudbranson. And it's intercepted. The Flyers get the breakaway going the other way. A chance to tie the game. And the save is made.
Atkinson just kind of ran out of room. Almost had to make the move too close to Greaves. And not able to get a shot off.
Johnny Gaudreau, left side. Sharp angle, right off the side of the net. Two fans thought it was in. But off the side, here's an attack. And it scores! Top of the circle. This one by Severson. So the Jackets get a couple of goals in the first period from their defenseman. 2-0.
Severson,
top of the circle, gets it back, fires, and scores! His second of the game. Third defenseman scoring. Severson with two and Gudbranson with one. It's 3-0 Columbus.
Penalty coming up here on Werenski.
Here's Hathaway in front and the Flyers score. And guess what? Finally, for Ulel Excel as he buries it, he has his first National Hockey League goal. All those chances. This one he buries. Flyers back in the game and Excel on the board.
Yeah, that's a determined effort from Hathaway to create the turnover and then make the finishing play over to Excel for his first NHL goal.
On here for Blankenberg. A wrist shot scores! There it is! You want him to score? And he does just that. Get Blankenberg. Jackets come right back and lead by three again.
Look at the space that it goes right through. I mean, what are the chances that puck escapes Marchenko and Sanheim and finds eyes in the top corner?
Flyers at this point need a shorthanded goal. They're going to get back into it.
There's a wrist shot. They score! Werenski just floating it, and again, whether it hit something or not, hard to tell, but it found its way into the net. Power play goal, and the Blue Jackets add to their lead, 5-1. Now Gauntz will drop it off, Malatesta turns, that bounces in front, and Werenski scores again. So Werenski now has two. 6-1, six goals from defensemen. They score here, Adam Schinning taking that shot if it wasn't deflected. Adam Schinning has his first NHL point and goal. For the first time since early December, they're on the outside looking in playoff race. Convincingly, Columbus knocks off Philadelphia 6-2.
Oh, I thought they played hard. I thought we made great strides last night. Tonight, at times, just seemed we were a step behind. I'm not sure if that's the back-to-back situation. No one's going to help us. We're just going to have to. We'll have tomorrow off. We'll practice, and we'll go on the road for a couple more and try to find our way. Being discouraged isn't going to help it. We just got to try to stay positive. Have a good practice day Monday. Get on a flight and get back to work.
Torts remains determined. The Flyers sat third in the Metro with a four-point cushion prior to this seven-game winless streak. They've allowed at least four goals in every game since March 24th and are in jeopardy of missing the playoffs altogether. In the Metro, the Flyers were jumped by the surging Penguins, while the Islanders held steady in third place with their win. This is shaping up to be a wild one, but worth noting, the Flyers do have the fewest games remaining with four. Speaking of wild, the East wild card is a doozy. Penguins have marched their way back into playoff position for now. The Flyers, Capitals, and Red Wings remain right on Pittsburgh's heels, with Detroit and Washington having one extra game in hand. You know the Battle of Alberta always delivers, and so does Connor McDavid. McDavid will look to keep his torrid season going as he tortures his rivals to the south. That's next.
Corner. Everybody trying to dig it out. And Perry thought he'd found his teammate. Huberdeau unable to pick the corner. Pickard the save. A chance for Hunt. And Darnell Nurse diving to help prevent that puck from going in.
The rebound comes out and Darnell Nurse a little dive to get right in the lane.
It'll be a penalty to Corey Perry for slashing. Handing it off. Backlund takes it. Looking for Miramont. He slips it by. We passed the midway mark of the first period. Still half a minute on the power play left for the Flames. Backlund to the blue line. Here's Anderson. Miramont on the blast. Off the post. Pickard stopping the rebound.
as he was scrambling, and the puck stays out.
The Oilers demand advantage. Oilers still controlling. Tries a look at it, and he scores! Fifth time in Dreisaitl's career to 40 goals, and that's the first one tonight here in the Battle of Alberta.
Warren Adams to Pahal. Pahal tried to slide it. The other way, two on one, the Oilers. Derek Ryan and Janmark. Derek Ryan moving to the middle. A chance. The Oilers up by two. Connor Brown's fourth of the season, taking advantage of opportunity there.
And that was a scramble play in front of Markstrom. He had no chance on this one. And slashing will be the call to Evander Kane. Fourth power play for the Flames.
Down low through Huberto. Looks, passes off his ankle. Shoots! Scores! Took only 11 seconds. Jared Domicic's 30th of the season. First time to 30 goals in his NHL career. Here's Weaver, unable to get it far. Here's McDavid and Hyman. McDavid and Hyman cannot get a shot on net. A 2-on-0, and Edmonton unable to take advantage. 3-on-2 for the Flames. Who's Maple? Sweet dish. Hospital. Nice move. Keeps. He couldn't put it home. Can you come much closer than that? Opportunity for the Flames to tie this one up here in the third period. Kuzmenko looks and finds Huberto. Godfrey parked out front. One-timer. Godfrey may have tipped it home, and it looks like he has. Corner to corner behind the net. Kuzmenko to Sharon Govich. The one-timer, and Godfrey in front gets rewarded by planting himself there. 2-2 score.
The Oilers are back on the man advantage. And now Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. Richard up.
And he scores! Top corner from the Oilers' blue liner, and the Oilers regain a one-goal lead.
They're looking to see maybe if this is a high stick, but I don't think that changes direction.
The review to call on the ice was confirmed. There was no high sticking on the play, therefore this is a goal.
Second consecutive season to 130 points for Connor McDavid. Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, and empty. Nugent-Hopkins corrals it and puts it home. The Oilers with a two-goal lead.
And Connor McDavid continues to amaze. Two assists Saturday, one shy of 100 helpers this season, and in the process, he eclipsed the 130-point mark for the second straight season, the first to do it since Mario Lemieux in the early 90s.
It's crunch time right now as the LA Kings are back home tonight. They take on the Vancouver Canucks. Maybe, just maybe, they'll meet in the first round of the playoffs. Billy Idol's here.
Star studded.
Wow. White wedding.
And the Kings will get an early power play. And across to the right wing boards again for Kempe. Down to the circle. Kempe a shot. He scores! Three games in a row with the first goal.
Tree was clean, shot was clean. Kings lead 1-0.
And now the Kings go back to work with the man advantage.
Canucks making things difficult on themselves early.
Down low at the goal line, Arvidsson across. Doughty scores! Power play goal number two. Drew Doughty and the Kings up 2-0.
Both shots, Kempe and Doughty, have been absolutely perfect.
Ian Cole is it, drops back to Pettersson, takes a look, passes to Besser, attacking from the side, gets it through, couldn't jam it home. I think Besser might have his 39th of the year as he continues to own the LA Kings in his career. The Canucks are on the board.
And after 20 minutes, 2-1, LA. Spence into the right wing corner, Vancouver zone. Feeds it out up high to Fiala. Fiala back in the middle. Spence a shot. He scores! Boy, the Kings are going to wear out those posts tonight. 3-1, LA.
It does hit the stick of Lafaria right there. That got the stick on the puck.
Nearing the 9-minute mark, second period, Kings up 3-1.
Looked on the ice, a deep shot, score! Kevin Fiala, calm as a cucumber right there, 4-1 LA.
DeSmith makes the initial stop, Fiala's already down, can push it over the line.
Nobody happier in this building than the great Billy Idol.
Hronek from center, nice pass, Miller's in, makes a move to the backhand, stop, rebound, they score! Dakota Joshua going to the net, and Joshua on the backhand put home the rebound to get the Canucks' second goal. It's 4-2.
And the Canucks cut into the lead. Don't go away just yet.
9.5 left to play. 4-2 LA. And here is Moore in front of Gibbon. Goal! Score! How many times have we seen that play down low this season? Moore, Deneau, and Moore. 5-2 LA.
And the Kings once again lead by three.
And the Kings 2 of 2 tonight on the power play. Get another crack at it.
Here come the Canucks shorthanded. Zadorov in. Centers. Loose puck to the side. They score. Teddy Bluger has finally bumped the slump. And he ends his drought. He'd gone 40 without a goal, but the Canucks are back within two.
And the Canucks looking to get back within one.
And here comes Kempe shorthanded.
Around a tired Hughes.
How about those Kings with two assists against the Pacific Division leading Canucks? Anze Kopitar became the third player in Kings history with 300 multi-point games. The others? Oh, just Marcel Dion and Luke Robitaille. I'm sure you've heard of them before. Here's how the Pacific Division looks after Saturday's action. The Kings jumped over the Golden Knights into third place with their win over Vancouver. Oilers inch closer, within 3 points of the Canucks with an extra game remaining. And the wild card standings look like this. Vegas in the first spot ahead of Nashville, who slid back to the second wild card spot after their loss on Saturday. Both are tied at 92 points. And the Blues' slim playoff hopes took a hit. They are 7 points back with 5 games left. Connor Bedard not only stated his Calder case loud and clear, but he also joined an elite group of 18-year-old goal scorers. Full highlights next. Blackhawks spoiling the Stars Saturday.
The Leafs have locked up a playoff spot.
I think we have a very deep, motivated group wanting to build off of getting to the second round last year. We want to go all the way.
I like Toronto more and more.
NHL Network is all over the playoffs.
Maverick Bourque, the Stars' 2020 first-round draft pick, makes his NHL debut. He earned this promotion with his brilliance in the American Hockey League.
The Stars' franchise record winning streak started 3 weeks ago tonight. They try to keep it going here as they take on the Chicago Blackhawks for the final time.
Gennardi with a chance for the play. Blocked by Robertson, who's got to get a breakaway into the hot zone. Left circle, fires Mrazek down with a nice butterfly save. Robertson now right circle off the play. Works it, found it, a great play defensively by Bedard.
Oh, right spot right there.
He had no bucket in warm-up all the way through. They allowed that with the youngsters. It was fun to watch.
In front, Marchman right off the bar, set up by Johnston, stayed out. You can hear it back in Dallas. He's got forward help, and then Anderson fell down, and Pavelski trying to break. Jones pursuing. Pavelski drops it. Hints, he drops it, and back off a stick. The Stars never get a shot out of it.
Might have got a tad too creative on that opportunity.
Bucked down behind the Hawk net. As it plays into the near corner, Stars get it, look out, hits in front, shoot, close save is made by Mrazek.
What a save. What a save that is.
First power play of the game. Hawks power play on home ice, 28th in the NHL.
Out to Bedard. He'll roll into the right circle. Toe drag fires, he scores! Off the left post, Connor Bedard with his 22nd goal of the season. Comes on a Hawk power play, and the Hawks lead 1-0. Kaiser lead pass. Michael breaking into the zone, also a drop pass, and Donatio shoots and scores! His first goal of the season! A beautiful drop pass by Reichel over to Athanasiou, wide open in the left wing circle. Wedgwood never had a chance, it's 2-0 Hawks. Entwistle over the line to Donato, left circle, Jones shoots and scores! Seth Jones makes it 3-0 Hawks, and a tic-tac-toe passing play to set him up.
That is a goal scorer's goal right there by Seth Jones.
Stars counterpunch. They've got possession across line. Pavelski to Haskinen. Perhintz scores! Perfectly working the width of the rink. And Haskinen on the blade of Roope Hintz gets Dallas on the board.
Haskinen nails it. It's elevated over top and the Stars are on the board.
Nice move by Haskinen. Shovels a backhand score! Ben was in front. The backhand let go from Haskinen, and with 4:23 left in the third, we'll see who gets it. The Stars have made it a one-goal game. 10 seconds to go. Flipped cross corner, Duchesne in front. It's loose, a backhand, and taken by the Hawks. They'll clear it to center. Johnson with it, and the horn sounds. It's in the franchise record 8-game winning streak. Comes to a close for Dallas here at United Center.
How about Connor Bedard finding the back of the net in the Blackhawks' win on Saturday to collect his 22nd goal of the season? In the last 15 years, only four other players have scored more goals in a season at the age of 18. Patrick Laine, Jeff Skinner, Nathan MacKinnon, and Steven Stamkos. Quite a group. Elsewhere in the Central, the Jets squared off against the Wild.
We are at Xcel Energy Center in St. Paul for the final time this season between the Winnipeg Jets and the Minnesota Wild. Winnipeg has won the first three matchups, so they're looking for the season sweep. Picked off by Marco Rossi, the 20-goal man as a rookie. Here comes Zuccarello. Center and pass right in, and a stop off Rossi by Hellebuck. Clean chance right there for the Wild.
Early action. It was Josh Morrissey. Once again, didn't waste much time jumping up offensively to create that chance.
One shot apiece here in the opening two and a half.
And Nemestikov scores! Vlad Nemestikov!
Chances at both ends, and then quickly the first goal from Winnipeg.
Boy, there is a lot to like about that fourth line for the Winnipeg Jets. Kirill Kaprizov always with the price of admission for Wildcat.
They score! Kaprizov on front! And it's number 38 on the season!
Quick little chip shot over the glove of Hellebuck, and just like that, that line has success. Potts won. We've got a tie game.
Two on one. Sean Monahan. He's got Connor with him. Monahan to Connor. Scores! Perfect setup, and Kyle Connor has given the Jets back their one goal lead.
Right on cue, he sauces one in tight onto the forehand of Kyle Connor, who gets his first goal in his last eight games, and quickly the Jets recover their lead.
Power play for Minnesota. Wild 4-for-10 against the Jets this year. Kaprizov scores!
And Kaprizov really looking like he's enjoying playing with Matt Zuccarello.
And a good response by Minnesota. Twice down one, twice they have an answer, and it's 2-2 after 20 minutes.
And Winnipeg has clinched their spot in the postseason, yet to be determined who they'll face and where they'll finish. But they know they're in the playoffs for the sixth time in the last 7 years.
Continue pressure from Winnipeg. Vlad Nemestikov tees it up. Dillon with a shot, he scores! Brendan Dillon with a bomb, and it's 3-2 Winnipeg.
Brendan Dillon, who extends his career high now to 9 goals. He's one shy of 10. And there's 12 players on this team already with 10 goals. That's a franchise record. Jets have their lead back off of the stick of number 5.
Chisholm again in touch. Rebound! Oh, that just missed the net. I'm not sure how. The trickle wide.
Oh, the Wild push to try to even this game at 3. Declan Chisholm, former Jet. There's the shot. And watch how close this goes. And then talk about a game of inches.
The second period comes to an end with Winnipeg in front by a goal.
And the Wild looking for a tying goal here. Came in with 36 wins on the season. They will not make the playoffs.
Shot. Score! Sandberg! It's tipped in front. It looks like Barron's goal. And that's some insurance. It's 4-2.
Excellent job from Morgan Barron to be there, to not interfere with Fleury. He gets a tap on that shot to an area that tips it up and over the glove. Extends the lead for Winnipeg to 4-2.
Jets are at full strength, 6-on-5 with the empty net.
And the Jets hang on to win 4-2. Now they're just 2 points trailing the Colorado Avalanche for second in the Central Division.
As we all know, it's been critical for Connor Hellebuck to get back into form for the Winnipeg Jets after going through a personal 5-game winless streak where he allowed 17 goals for an .878 save percentage. In his last 2 games against the Wild and Flames, he's been the heli we know, stopping 56 of 60 shots faced. And here is the three-horse race in the Central. 5 games left to play. Jets pull within 2 points of the idle Avs, who are 3 points back of the Stars. Dallas and Colorado will meet Sunday night in Denver. Delicious.
All season long has sparked his team when they absolutely needed something, and he came by the bench after this scrap here, getting his line, getting his team going. As you can see, a good finish check on Neighbors as helmet gets dislodged.
0-0 game with 5 and change to go here in the second. Granlund, and now Thrun on the wing. Eklund, he scores! William Eklund breaks through, and the Sharks take a 1-0 lead. There's only 15 seconds left. Granlund to the net, rejected. Borlaug, save, rebound, they score! It's Eklund again!
the recipient of all five guys pulling their weight, working together. And there's Eklund coming on the other side of the net and in the net for the second power play goal of the game.
In the slot, Buchnevich to Kyrou, to Buchnevich. Now Kyrou with it, shoots, and he scores! Kyrou into the top corner, a power play goal, and it's 2-1.
Well, we talked about that momentum swinging for the Blues. Started with that fight. Guy like Colton Parayko does something a little out of character. That motivates the team. They follow up with a power play. Jordan Kyrou putting that thing top shelf with Braden Schenn taking away the goalie's eyes in front.
Blues have pulled the goalie here. 2:37 left. And they win the faceoff. And Krunovich throws it low. Thomas in front. And they score! Schenn has tied the game with 2:29 to go with the goaltender off. And it's 2-2.
What a goal that was. And he just shovels it out in front on the backhand to the captain, Braden Schenn, who's right there for the one-timer. Tying this game up. That's a huge goal for the Blues.
Eklund to the puck behind the San Jose net. He'll skate ahead now against Schenn. Eklund with speed. He's got McDonald with him 2-on-1. Eklund shoots.
Series, and Devin Cooley gets what he so wanted all day and all his hockey life, a W in the show.
William Eklund was the hero with the AstraZeneca hat trick. The Sharks took a huge bite out of St. Louis's playoff hopes. When John Williams was writing the iconic theme song for Jaws, it was these Sharks he was thinking of. They have been an absolute terror for the Blues, outscoring them 12-3 in the three-game series sweep. Coming up, Mitch Marner back on the ice. A welcome sight for Leafs fans. Also, a welcome sight, how about number 64 for number 34? Highlights next on The Fly.
Tonight was going to be enough of a challenge already for the Canadians. The Austin Matthews goal-scoring tour comes to town. Mitch Marner returning from injury. The Leafs went 12 games without Marner over the last 4 weeks.
And Suzuki is in. Nick Suzuki off the post and out.
Well, you talk about two guys who know where to find each other. The chemistry between Suzuki and Caulfield, from that angle, all you've got really is up over the shoulder, and you can see Suzuki look skyward as soon as he hit it.
Action starting to pick up here in the late stages of this first period. Done one here in Montreal. Comes around for Matthews. He let it go for LaBouche. Good shot.
By Domi.
Okay.
In front.
No, Domi does get it.
Yeah, he had good position there. Labushkin with his head up, and there's Domi on the doorstep. Nice play by Labushkin to put that in an area where Domi was able to get a piece of it.
Leafs get the icebreaker here early in the second period, looking for more for Tuesday. Matthews with it. It's 64, and how many more for Austin Matthews?
One thing about Matthews that he's done numerous times from this side is just get it to the front of the net. He misses it the first time. Domi's looking for a tap in, and Matthews quickly gets around Matheson and off the skate of Savard, and bang, just like that, it's a 2-0 game.
Nylander from distance, rebound, scores. Matthew dies, and it's 96 points for William Nylander.
Right on the doorstep, Nyes gets to the front of the net, got kind of left alone as everybody focused on the puck, not looking behind.
Reeves, who had a heavyweight tilt with Tanner Jeannot on Wednesday night, right back to work here against Pezzetta. And Pezzetta in tough form. Reeves sends a message to the rest of the bench as well. Marner on the right side. McMahon to the net! Scores! Marner to McMahon, and it's 4-0.
Here, all of a sudden, in this second period, you've got line 1, 2, and 3 all getting involved. And there's a great example of what Marner's able to do. Perfectly laid out there in front, just underneath the glove.
By Pezzetta, passes it down low. Slavkovsky across, scores. Nick Suzuki, power play goal. 33 for the captain.
But how about the adjustment by Suzuki? Gets down on one knee to try to get his hand as low as he could to get all of that one. And he made that look easy.
Matheson's on the move.
Matheson and Fox goes! Caulfield pulls in three straight for Caulfield.
And the recipient on the doorstep won't miss many of those.
A six-goal second period with the puck. Here's Matthews. Off the post. Goes to 65. And the Maple Leafs, they have capped a regular season sweep.
Not bad. First couple shifts, you know. It's always that first one where you get hemmed in the zone. You start feeling it through the eyelids, but I felt good out there. You know, obviously, have a lot of support out there with speed and some very skilled players. So try to do my thing and, you know, make them better, and as they did the same with me.
You know, obviously, spreads out our depth quite a bit, and I mean, with him back, it gives us a lot of different options. Obviously, a boost to the power play, a boost to the penalty kill, and a boost for us 5-on-5, and just what he does for the team and his all-around play. So it's obviously great to have him back, and you know, I thought their line was really good tonight too.
Austin was really good tonight and has been good the whole season, increasing his lead at 64 on the season, leading all goal scorers. In doing so, he reached 100 points for the second time in his career. Leafs legends Doug Gilmour and Daryl Sittler are the only other players in franchise history to record multiple 100-point seasons. Staying north of the border, Devils, Ottawa, Senators.
Devils starting with a new look, second line of Jesper Bratt, Eric Halla, and Jack Hughes. Jack Hughes feeds Eric Halla, he scores! A flying start for the Devils. It's a 1-0 lead.
Eric Halla just holding his lane, and on the second shot of the game, once more, the Senators find themselves down 1-0.
Third line is out here now, Alexander Holtz for Luke Hughes, deflected, score! Andre Palat flashing in front, he tips it through Forsberg.
Nothing fancy, simple. Get the shot through. Great little tip.
Brendan Smith corrals. Feed blasts. He scores! His second goal in as many days, and his second goal in two games in Ottawa this year. That was a laser.
Who is this guy?
Brendan Bobby Orr Smith.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, he's on an offensive tear.
Goaltending change for the Ottawa Senators here is Jonas Korpisalo is going to come in to replace Anton Forsberg. They'll hand it off for Batherson to the point. Sanderson with a shot, scores! Sanderson gets the power play goal, and Ottawa is on the board. And he's just going to lay this out to Sanderson, who's going to pull it to the middle of the ice until he finds the lane that he likes, and then he just lets it go.
Rack to the front, Hischier, he scores! Nico Hischier from Jesper Bratt, and it's 4-1.
This is intelligence. This is just high hockey IQ, as we say. He continues his fine play with a beautiful assist there.
One for one tonight. Maybe they could get another one here. Paul Giroux scores! Paul Giroux, power play goal!
Back-to-back power play goals for the Senators on their two-man advantages today.
Puts it right in his wheelhouse.
Zoom blocks it across. Jack Hughes intercepts. He is off to the races. Hughes on the break. He deeps. Korpisalo puts it away.
Coming
but
up.
A penalty coming.
Penalty shot.
Kicks in Korpisalo, but Jack Hughes gets a penalty shot after he was hooked on the way in. Cuts in and lost the puck.
One of those things where, you know, it's a tough break. He just kind of mishandles the puck. Lost control.
That's the first one. We'll mark it out. Into the Devils bench. He welcomes the battle, and then he'll branch off and he'll just bury somebody else. Ben's chanting the captain's name here. It's Brady Tkachuk, and he's got it down the wing. Scores! The captain lights the lamp at Ottawa's within one.
Right as the puck was ricocheting that way, and it's 4-3.
We got a one-goal game again here.
Comes back to him. Settled down. Batherson blocked. Tkachuk, no rebound.
Oh, hit the post.
Because he put the puck into the empty net after the horn. We've seen a couple of empty net goals in this building cause a hullabaloo.
A lot of competitive fire there. Luke Hughes continues to shine in his rookie year. With the assist he picked up in the Devils' win, Hughes now has 44 points on the season, tying him with Will Butcher for the most by a rookie defenseman in Devils team history. And Hughes still has 5 games left to break the record. Time now for your Top Shelf Plays.
Shot. Got it again towards the net. The rebound. Score! Bunting! Pittsburgh! Back on
nice tip there right in front to Bunting. That's a huge goal as they try to fight their way back into the playoffs.
Here's Reichel breaking into the zone. Oh, slide drop pass. Anthony Seu shoots and scores! His first goal of the season. A beautiful drop pass by Reichel. Wedgwood never had a chance. It's 2-0 Hawks.
Boquist scores! Jesper Boquist wins it in overtime. Boquist puts it away.
Down to the circle, can't be a shot. He scores! Three games in a row. Adrian Kempe and the Kings are up early.
Here's Hathaway in front, and the Flyers score! Finally, for Ulrich Salas, he buries it. He has his first National Hockey League goal. All those chances, this one he buries. Lixell on the board in the NHL.
Matthews with it.
We are coming to you from Utica, New York. The final game of day four at these 2024 Women's Worlds.
Finland's power play will go to work.
Holopainen now on the far side, taking a look. Let's just go. She scores! On the power play, Lisa Holopainen gets Finland in the lead.
Well, this is a Finnish team that needs momentum, and they get it.
Bobby Murphy cuts to center. She's Bilka on the far side. Drops it for Harvey. Bilka takes a look. Wrap around. She scores! Hannah Bilka ties the game. Finland to the power play. Holopainen fakes a shot. She scores! Her second power play goal in the game. And we're all tied up with two. I'm going to shake you off. Cavalcoy Schofield lets it go. She scores! Cavalcoy Schofield does it again. The United States leads 4-2. All alone, a chance for Sundelin on the backhand. She scores! Sofiana Sundelin gets Finland within one. Out in front, turnover for Alex Carpenter in front, backhand, Hillary Knight off the post. Oh my goodness, without a stick, Kendall Coyne Schofield completes it. Her second of the night, the United States will defeat Finland 5-3.
Here's a look at Group A in the Women's World Championship, where the United States is leading the way at 3-0 with the most goals scored, followed closely by Team Canada, who will take on the U.S. in a heavyweight battle on Monday. Time for your three stars of the night. Third star, Adrian Kempe, led the Kings with two goals and an assist in their 6-3 win over the Canucks. Kempe became the first King to score 30 goals this season. William Eklund, second star, recorded his first career hat trick in the overtime win against the Blues. Eklund had never had a multi-goal game prior to Saturday. And your first star, Semyon Varlamov, stopped all 41 shots he faced against the Predators, helping his team inch closer to a playoff clinch in this wild race. Before we go, a very nice moment from Pittsburgh on Saturday afternoon after Evgeny Malkin scored his second goal of the game. Broadcast cameras caught his parents in the stands crying tears of joy. Despite this being Malkin's 74th multi-goal game in the NHL, plus countless others during his journey to the National, they were still brought to tears watching their son excel. Wonderful stuff there. That's all for this edition of On the Fly. I'm Tony Loughman. We leave you now with the best from a busy Saturday.
As we get set for action here this afternoon, here a little matinee hockey for you.
Down to center ice we go.
He lands a couple of big rights.
It's 64, and how many more?
Ulrich Salas, he buries it. He has his first
NHL goal. Get out of front.